Hi, I'm Satan's favorite puppet, Chris Strouth, and we're on the highway to hell. Welcome to the special holiday edition of What? For those of you watching in the St. Paul metro area on cable access channel 33, happy Halloween. Ooh, scary. And for those of you watching in the Minneapolis metro area, Merry Christmas and all those other seasonal type greetings. Tonight we've got a really special show for you that I think you're really going to enjoy. Couple of guys named Ron, Mike, and Jerry, a band called No Apparent Reason, and here they are now.
She's telling lies, and I know that it's for sure. She's telling lies, and I know that it's for sure. She's always told me this one. Her and me, but now I know, should I stay or maybe should she go? Oh no, I was told that she would be true, but now what can I do? I'm still in love with you. She's telling lies, and I know that it's for sure. She's telling lies. Was gonna be, we'd be together, yeah, her and me. But now I know, should I stay or maybe should she go? Oh no, I was told that she wouldn't be true, but now what can I do? I'm still in love with you. She's telling I know that it's for sure. She's telling lies, and I know that it's for sure. She's telling lies. She's telling lies. She's telling lies. She's telling lies. So,
what'd you have for breakfast this morning?
I had potatoes and eggs.
Potatoes and eggs? Mm-hmm. Where'd you have, did you make it at home?
Yeah,
at
sure.
Restaurant?
Made it at home. I was on my, you know, I've already heard your breakfast story, so I'll tell mine. I was on my way to get some work done and fried up some potatoes, and I had a couple of eggs. But I didn't go out.
In case you wondered what rock stars have for breakfast, we're the only show in town that's going to tell you. The bean in this fine restaurant, right, we've got to kind of keep going on with it.
Yeah.
What'd you have for breakfast?
I had spaghetti.
You had spaghetti for breakfast?
Right, yeah.
That is so sick.
So it was like probably at like 3 in the afternoon,
about 2:30.
And it was cold.
Did you make it to the uptown?
No, he reheated it.
I reheated it. I almost burned it though. It started burning up, but it was good.
It's a sad little lonely life, isn't
kind
it,
Mike? Skinny spaghetti, whatever that's called. Vermicelli.
Angel.
That's about it. Yeah.
A nicer pasta for breakfast on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. What'd you have for breakfast?
I had pizza, potato chips for breakfast.
Pizza and potato chips.
Yeah.
Where was the pizza from?
It was from Snyder's.
Snyder's brand pizza. I see. Yeah. Well, only the Wolfgang Puck's Snyder's brand.
Yeah. It was wonderful. Yeah.
It's three for $5 food.
It's a sorry little life, isn't it? Got a favorite cartoon show.
Actually quite a few. When I was smaller, I liked Johnny Quest a lot. Johnny Quest was a good show. And still a fan of, you know, any Warner Brother cartoon, really. Bugs Bunny, he rules.
Indeed.
Yes.
Well, Bugs is the master.
He is the master. Mm-hmm.
And with
Bullwinkle.
Well, okay, there he goes.
You got an original answer.
Yeah.
Underdog.
Yeah.
That was a good
one.
Underdog is huge.
Yeah. I used to play
Underdog
when I was a kid.
3 hours later.
Yeah, sorry.
I don't know.
Oh yeah.
Mr. Sandman, I'm glad you've come today. My box is getting empty. Too many wanna play. Oh. There is this one girl. Today.
We'll be right back with more what right after these messages. Oh, waitress, more Java here, please.
Have you ever been hungry? Have you ever wondered where your next meal would come from? I have. A long time ago, people like these meant a lot to me and my family. They're giving their time, food, and money, their love, because they know anyone can be hungry. Have you ever needed a place to stay, clothes to keep you warm? These people are giving their time, money, and extra clothing, their love, because they know that anyone can be homeless. You know, some people who were donating their food and clothing last year are eating with us today. Life is a round table. What we put on it comes back to us. Open your hearts to the hungry and homeless in your community. Give to your local food and shelter programs, because when someone is down and needs help, don't question, just help them.
Find out how you can help. Call 1-800-652-9747.
Watching Cable Access, St. Paul, Minnesota.
Now, what about the name? Who came up with the name? What's the story on that? It's kind of a goofy name, a lot different from a Love Weasel or
Mike's story to tell, I think.
We were
8 years ago.
So, yeah, eight years ago. This is kind of a second incarnation. But 8 years ago, I think I was at Stevens Point with another friend who used to sing with Ron and I and a couple other people. And people kept bugging us and asking us why we're doing this. You know, why a band? Why this rock and roll thing? And I think we said it's really for no apparent reason. Yeah. There's the band name we've been searching for. We thought lots of vile, stupid, and fit. I don't know why. No particular.
Oh, the no apparent reason. Oh. I guess would have been the perfect joke there, but you really missed it.
Well, yeah,
that's okay.
It's you know, we've been together for almost just over 6 years now, so we've heard enough of that no apparent reason kind of ba-dum-bum chick.
Yeah, but so. You know. But it's fresh here, isn't it?
It's our fault.
Yeah, it's our fault.
We brought it on ourselves.
So you guys have any recorded media out?
We did a five song EP 3 years ago.
Yep.
A little record that hangs around occasionally.
Still available in your local record bins.
Yeah.
If they still have it. If they still have record bins.
And we have a couple of tapes that we recorded, but we haven't put them out. Doing those with some that we've been working on last December and January. We're gonna finish up and put out probably a tape, precursor to a disc.
And kind of give it out as a kind of a freebie.
Kind of a Christmas or Halloween gift.
Yes, exactly.
I'm there for you.
I'm there for you. Yeah.
Thank you. So I deliver Daisy's daily. Thank me for that. Come right through me, come right to me. Now I want you back. The night won't be home till you're coming. Laughter in the room, wanting to with the plan that's made to go. The hub. We heard this before. Take our picks and open up the door. Then you go this way, then you go that way. Are you coming back for more? Delilah, won't be home to the glory. Like the rich Jerusalem, running through the San Diego.
For a day job?
Freelance theater design and stuff like that. Lights, mostly.
So you don't really have a job then?
No, I don't. It's true, I don't. I mean, I work every day, but no, I don't have a job, per se.
The homeless.
I work at a lighting company, a rental, theatrical lighting rental house. Yeah. And I do design work. Don't give any free
lighting design. No. Well, that's against the rules, isn't it? Yeah. Well, that's okay. It doesn't matter. Yeah. I work it.
Yeah.
Some place.
Work with all the biggies. All the biggies.
Wow.
It's huge. And
Northrop, you know it.
Yeah, of course.
And I work for a record company in town. Local
tell
record
him.
Company.
Tell them. Tell them.
Tell them. Tell them.
You can go ahead and plug record labels.
Okay.
Sometimes they give us free stuff then, so
yeah,
we're okay
cool.
with that.
Yeah. Yeah, I work at Ryko Disc in town, and I'm in the international sales department.
I thought it was
very exciting.
Assistant international
sales manager. I have a title.
Well, then why don't you say that?
Well,
I mean,
yeah. Okay.
All right. There it is.
Yeah, and that's my job.
That's very exciting.
It's
so
exciting.
One person without a job, one person with a job, and one person with a career.
Oh.
Yeah.
He met Yoko. Oh, we have careers.
And
wow.
Didn't he Yoko?
Song about a Beatles man. So, Rod, I'm singing, but we're all doing background vocals on it. I'm Paul McCartney.
Paperback writer, paperback writer.
It's a little matter for you. I think it took me years to write. When you take a look, it's based on a novel by the man. Paperback writer. It's a dirty story of a dirty man, and his grinning wife doesn't understand. Son is working for the Daily Mail, gets a steady job, but he wants to be a paperback writer. Paperback writer.
Paperback writer. Paperback writer.
Sorry about that last one.
Well, thanks for joining us on this special holiday edition of What? I'd like to give a big round of thanks to our special band, No Apparent Reason. I'm sure we'll be hearing a lot from them in the months ahead. So we'll be seeing you next time on What?
Oh.
Ooh. Ooh. What did you mean by that?
Nothing.
Is there something wrong with my hair?
I love your hair. I think it's great.
What are you talking about? Crystal Gale?
What? What?
You know,
Can we get some more?
I want some ketchup, man.
I'd just like to point out that 2 days ago I was walking down Nicollet Mall in Minneapolis, which is the other city, and a Japanese tourist took my photo. And I just figured it was because of the show, really, that like I'm a huge thing in Japan.
Cool.
But
cool.
These people came up and like, you know, took my photo, and it was really cool.